For this video, we're going to work through variations of weak acid problems, either being given Ka values or asking to solve for Ka values. And so the most common ones we work, number one, we've already worked that if we're given the initial acid concentration and a Ka value, we solve for hydronium to then find pH. Examples from the textbook that cover that type of problem are listed here. The next most common example, and this is used in class, but more often in a lab setting, where if we know the initial acid concentration and pH, we can actually use that information to solve for hydronium and then a Ka value. Example 1411 is an example of this. Two other practice problems that given pH and Ka, we can actually solve for the initial acid concentration, or given initial concentration and percent dissociation, we can again find our Ka value. And a note for you, I've mentioned and we've discussed Ka and Kb values. Again, these should always be looked up. For purposes of classwork, you should always refer to the appendix in our textbook. These are also linked in our Canvas pages. Google will get you close to these numbers, but if you're doing it for a graded assignment, make sure you're using the official value from the textbook if a value is not given in a problem. For this video, we're going to work through these three problems, and I'm going to work through them pretty quickly. So what I strongly recommend is to pause the video and set up your ice table for each of these three problems and see how far you can get with the setup so that when we solve through them, you will have your setups already and you can just check yourself or make sure you know how to do the last steps on them. All right, so again, we want to calculate Ka of HCN. If we're asked to find a Ka value, that's also a hint that this is a weak acid, meaning this is going to set up equilibrium, and we set up our ice table. We only know our initial concentration of the acid. Our starting values for our products are going to be zero because we weren't told anything about them. So this reaction has to go forward. For our equilibrium expression, we again have products over reactants. Everything is first order because of our coefficients of one. So at equilibrium, we have this math setup. Now, we're solving for a Ka value. We can't set this equal to anything yet, but in order to solve for Ka, it means we need to know an X value. Remember in here that because I'm working with an acid, my X is my hydronium concentration. And again, this is hydronium at equilibrium. That's always when pH is measured. Notice the next piece of information we're given in here is that pH is 5.15. And if you remember from early on in our equations, we manipulated our pH equation to solve for hydronium. So hydronium is 10 to the minus pH, which is 10 to the minus 5.15. And make sure you get in the habit of using the function of 10. So this is the inverse of your log base 10 raised to the negative 5.15. That is a value of 7.0795. Extra digits here because it's not final answer. And times 10 to the minus 6. Since that's X, it is a concentration in our ice table. That is now our X value, and that can now be plugged into our equilibrium expression. Key thing to note is that it can be plugged into both the numerator and the denominator. All right, we have x squared on top, and then we have the 0.10 minus x. Since we know the value of x, we're going to put it in here. We say that it's zero and take it out to avoid having to do the quadratic, but since we know the value, we're going to use it in here. And we review sig figs. We're given two sig figs in concentration. We're given two decimal places in pH. So that's going to take us to two sig figs in our final Ka value. Ka is a small number, 5.0 times 10 to the minus 10. That makes sense for a weak acid. Our second calculation, we want to know the initial concentration of a benzoic acid. I don't know the formula of that off the top of my head. I can get pretty close, but I'm not quite sure what it is. So I'm just going to use HA for benzoic acid. But I see that I'm given a Ka in here. So I assume it's a weak acid, or I know it's a weak acid. Again, we're told the temperature, that's just to confirm our K value. We don't know our initial acid concentration. We can go ahead and set up the rest of our ice table though. We can set up our equilibrium expression as products over reactants. And we can plug in our numerical quantities set equal to our given Ka value. Now realize here we are given a pH, and so like we did in the previous problem, we can use that value to solve for the X. Again, because this is an acid, our X is our hydronium. That is calculated as 10 to the minus pH. And so our X value is 0.00, extra digits here, 30903. So again, that's my X value that can go in for both of those quantities. So putting my x squared in the numerator gives me a 9.5499 times 10 to the minus 6. In the denominator, I have my question mark minus my 9.5499 times 10 to the minus 6. Set that equal to our Ka value. Easiest way to solve this one, the next step is to switch my answer and my denominator. Oh, I just wrote the wrong number. Sorry. In my denominator, I have the question mark minus my x value. Sorry, I used my x squared. This would be minus the 0.0030903. And so now my setup is my x squared, the 9.5499 times 10 to the minus 6, divided by 6.3. times 10 to the minus 5 equal to the question mark minus my x value. So my ratio here becomes a 0.15159. That is equal to question minus my x. Add this to both sides. But what we'll see by the time we round for sig figs is that truly in this case, this bottom denominator X does not make a difference. And so I'm kind of working to the left now. So our question mark is 0.15159 plus our X value of 0.0030903. And again, we're limited to two sig figs. We have two sig figs in Ka, we have two decimal places in pH, and so our initial concentration of acid was a 0.15 molar. And the last variation that will work here is calculating the Ka of a solution of acetic acid if we know the percent dissociation. So again, setting up an ice table. And you could just as easily use HA here again, but we know the formula of this acid. Our products start at zero, they increase by X, and so at equilibrium we just have X. We have our equilibrium expression first. Plugging in our equilibrium values. And then of course we want to solve for Ka here. So the difference in this question is that we are given the percent dissociation. Remember, our equation for percent dissociation is x divided by our initial times 100. And so in this scenario, we are solving for x. We do know our initial acid concentration, and we know that our overall percent dissociation is the 1.9%. So we use this equation to solve for X. When you move all of this around, your X is a 9.5 times 10 to the minus 4. And so up here for our Ka value, I'm going to plug that into my X. So 9.5 times 10 to the minus 4 squared over 0.050 minus 9.5 times 10 to the minus 4. Again, I've just plugged my X values in here. And our Ka value here, we're still going to go to 2 sig figs. Both the concentration and percent dissociation go to 2. So we get a 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. And in fact, if you remember or if you look up, that is the true K value for acetic acid. The last slide that I'll leave you with is this one with practice problems. So similar to what we just worked, variations on what you're asked to solve for, the answers are included here. So you can pause the video and check yourself. Or if you have the slides, the answers are left in the slides as well.